What are the bare minimum network protocols which one should know while designing a system? Now, this is something which comes in very handy when they are given or thrown a problem statement. That, for example, hey Anubhav, can you design a chatting application? Now, what will Anubhav do? Anubhav will create three boxes: a UI, a backend, and maybe a backend too, or a database. And then he will say that I will call this API from UI to backend, and then I'll call this API from backend to backend too. But what about the network protocol? Will it be TCP? Will it be UDP? Will it be WebRTC? Will it be RTMP? Will it be the traditional REST? There are so many options, and all of these options have their own use cases. So in this video, I'm going to cover what are the right protocol for the right use cases so that you can map your requirement and choose that if it is a chatting application, I might use WebSockets. If it is a regular request and response, I might use REST. So let's get started. Now I will divide the communications into two sections. One is noisy communication and the other is non-noisy communication. For non-noisy communication, there will be simple requests, simple response. A client makes a request, they make the request to the server processes the data and gives them the response. There is no chattiness between the client and the servers. By noisy communication, in the gaming application, both the client and the server will have the communication, and those communication will be chatty. For non-noisy communication, if we zoom in between the UI and the backend, so what will be the UI options? Browsers, apps, they can be Android app or iOS apps, etc. And what will be the backend services? They will be the services hosted on cloud, and they would be written in Java or C++ or C#. So the communication between the client and the server happens mostly through browsers or through applications. So they need to be supported on those user machines. So the first one is from the user machine, and the second one is from the cloud. This communication happens through REST. The REST protocol can be called using HTTP 1, HTTP 2, or even HTTP 3. HTTP 3 is fairly new protocol. That is, it is also called as Quick QUIC, and it has recently called the RFC number. So it's not as popular as HTTP 2 and 1, and they are being heavily used in the front-end world. Of course, the backend needs to support them. Now the backend will get the data and they will process the request from the UI. Now coming to the communication between the backend services, that is backend 1 to backend 2. So these communication can happen over multiple methods. These methods can be either REST or gRPC. gRPC is quite new technology, developed in 2015 by Google, and it helps in faster communication between services. There is some facility from the UI to the backend as well, but till now there are proxies which help in communicating between the UI to backend when they want to communicate using gRPC. So it's not as simple and adds the burden of having a proxy server using which the UI would communicate to the proxy server and then communicate to the backend. Hence, I'm eliminating that option for now because I would want the gRPC to get more matured from the front end to the backend world. So you can see that using proxy, you can communicate from the client or the user to the backend. But this is something which will add the hop. Instead, you can have a REST call and communicate between the client and the server. So overall, now we can see that we have two methods. One is REST and one is gRPC whenever we are building the communication between the services. This was all about the non-noisy communications. Now we'll move on to the noisy communications. The noisy communication can be because of gaming, chatting, or video streaming, video calling. So in those cases, typical HTTP request and response wouldn't help, because in HTTP request and response, you would send a request, then the request will be processed and you will get a response. So you would need to create connections if it is HTTP 1. Even HTTP 2 wouldn't help in many of the cases. So now we'll look into the more noisy communication part. If you want to involve backend in your communication, that is Client will make the request to the backend, and then the backend will communicate to the client, for example, in chatting or video streaming, etc. In those cases, you can use WebSockets. WebSocket is a protocol which sits over TCP. So in this way, the communication between the various components can be done. But if you want even modern world thing, for example, video calling, in those cases, you would need UDP protocol. And for supporting the UDP protocol, you can use WebRTC. So that's the second option. So with the help of WebRTC, you can connect between the clients and the server, or you can have a peer-to-peer connection as well. WebRTC is a modern technology using which a lot of chatting and the calling applications, for example, Discord for chatting, and for video calling, Zoom and Teams, they use WebRTC while communicating and video streamings. In fact, for the video streaming, YouTube also uses WebRTC. So overall, these two methods, either using WebSockets, which runs on top of TCP, or using WebRTC, which runs on top of UDP, but in WebRTC, it's negotiable. That is, with the help of WebRTC, they have technologies where they check that what are the various protocols supported in both the clients. And if both the clients support UDP, they go ahead with UDP. If one of the clients support TCP and other supports both, then they communicate over TCP. So WebRTC is quite modern and very efficient and sophisticated technology being used by multiple players. So feel free to use it as well. This is the overall picture of what I have explained so far. If you have a communication which is non-noisy, a simple request and response, and it is from UI to backend, in those cases, you can use REST call. All create, read, update, delete APIs which are there in the REST call. You can run them on top of HTTP 1, 2 or 3. 3 is quick. If it is a non-noisy application and it is between service to service, you can use either gRPC or REST. REST will be easier but a little slower. Otherwise, you can use gRPC if you want faster performance. If the communication is noisy, for example, gaming application, chatting application, video streaming, in those cases, you can use TCP or UDP. If you are using TCP, then you can use WebSockets, which use TCP underneath. And if you are using UDP, if you want to prefer UDP, because a lot of video calling applications like Zoom and Teams, they use UDP. In those cases, you can use WebRTC. So with the help of this complete picture, you can solve lots of system design problems. So that's all for this video. Please like and comment if you like it. It really makes a difference. Till the next time. Bye.